Today we'll introduce crowdfunding from Podbean and how you get started on setting it up. So right now I'm logged in to my Podbean account, and if I want to get started, I would click on My Crowdfunding. If you didn't already have a crowdfunding campaign, you would click on Add New, and the first thing you're going to have to do is type in your Podbean, your podcast URL, feed URL, and then it will take you to your crowdfunding page. If you are a podcaster who doesn't use Podbean for your podcast, you will be given some verification coding to input into your most recent episode that verifies your podcast. But if you're on Podbean, it'll go directly to your crowdfunding campaign. Since I've already set one up, I'm just going to go to Edit to walk through the steps of how this would be done. So basically, this is the page you're going to get. It's pretty straightforward. And once I've put in my feed, it gives that right here. It asks me to put the name of the podcaster. So at the top of your crowdfunding page, it will have your podcast name and then by so-and-so. And this is the so-and-so. So you can put your name or your title of your podcast, whatever you want to go by. You should definitely upload a photo, and that's used for the snapshot for your podcast crowdfunding. So you want to have that there. It should be 960 by 540 or pretty close to that. We also highly recommend that you do an introduction video. Video is very compelling for your listeners to see your message and to see why you want to have crowdfunding and have their support. So we highly recommend shooting a brief video, just sharing your story and some information there. But you definitely are required to have a photo. The video is optional but recommended. You type in your story here. So this is, again, sort of, you might have that in a video, but you also have your text information that just gives an introduction to who you are and why you need support and what you're going to use your pledges for. So you type that in that simple editor right there. As we scroll down, we see goals. Your goals are milestones that you want to reach for funding, so amounts that you hope to reach and what you plan to do with those funds. This is great for your potential supporters to see what kind of things you're going to use the money for, and then also to see how your crowdfunding is progressing. So we've listed three goals here. One is a small sort of attainable goal, which we highly recommend. It shows you're making progress in your campaign, and it shows something reasonable and attainable. So we recommend something fairly reasonable for that. We're going to do an equipment upgrade, and we've typed in a little description. We have a higher goal that, in this case, since it's a travel podcast, we're going to use to create a special, so an additional set of podcasts, and in this case, it'll help fund the related travel. And then another goal for a further series. So we have three goals there. You should at least give one goal, again, to show a milestone, but preferably a couple goals. That way you can go forward with your progress over time. The rewards for your patrons, we suggest starting out at small amounts, $1 preferably, and then going from there. And we recommend also having a few amounts that are pretty reasonable, pretty low, because this is a monthly amount that they'll be pledging. So it's recommended to have a couple things that are under $20 a month. Those are the levels you're likely going to get from most listeners. So we've started out with $1 and provided the details of what we're going to give. In this case, we're just kind of giving a thanks, and we're reminding them that in the patron campaign, there's a comment section for people that pledge. It's strictly for them, so you might want to solicit certain comments, feedback there, and say that, we're going to take a polling from our comments for something we're going to incorporate into the podcast. In this case, being a travel podcast, we said that we'd love to hear their comments on what destinations they would like to hear about. We did a $2 also, which includes a listing on our site. Listings and shout-outs on the podcast are a great thing at these lower levels. For $5, we did a bonus premium episode that they can get. You can also include things like ebooks or other materials or things you've done. You can think about virtual rewards, such as doing a Google Hangout or creating a special Facebook page just for members at certain levels. And then we did also a $10 a month amount, which gives them access to our members-only tipped newsletter. So there's lots of great ideas that you can come up with about rewards, creative rewards you can offer. If you have show products, if you have t-shirts or things like that, those are also great, of course. And things maybe related to what your podcast is all about. And then there's the chance to do an optional thank you message, which we highly recommend because that pops up right after the donor supports you. And when you do all that, you'll just want to hit save there. And this page is what pops up next, which gives you the URL for your crowdfunding campaign, which you'll want to share as much as possible, of course. You can share it directly to Facebook and Twitter here. And you can, we'll show you in another video about managing your crowdfunding, about looking at who your patrons are, managing that information, getting your payouts, which you can get monthly from any amounts that have been donated, and also how to create badges for other sites. If you're a Podbean podcaster, you'll have a patron button automatically once you set this up in your Podbean site. But of course, you may have your own URL, and those that aren't on Podbean are using other sites, and you'll want to place a badge directly on your site so users can see it right there. Also, for those that are listening in the Podbean app, one of the great things about Podbean crowdfunding is there's a button directly in the app. So when someone's listening to you there, they can just click right there, and in only a couple of steps, they can donate. So we've tried to make it as easy as possible so that people don't have to take extra steps. So that's just a little tour of crowdfunding, and now let me show you what this campaign looks like now that it's complete. So this is our title and our name. This is the picture that we uploaded. Once we start getting patrons, that will show up here and will show the progress towards our goal. The patrons can click right there to become a patron, and they have share buttons to share your campaign. When you scroll down on the right-hand side, you see the rewards that were inputted. As you scroll over them, you have the choice to select that option. So it lists the different rewards we came up with and what those are. And the nice thing is on the left here, we have our story. So whatever you've typed in here about this crowdfunding campaign, and it automatically pulls from your RSS feed your latest episodes. So right here, people, if they go to this and maybe they haven't listened to your podcast or they haven't seen the latest episode, they can see what you're all about there. And it's all integrated right in. Then our goals are right here. And so you can see the three different goals that we added. And as mentioned before, there's a comments section. So this is patrons only, and this is a way that you can interact with your patrons, thank them again, talk about different topics, that kind of thing, encourage them to share it. So that's pretty straightforward and simple. When you're in that page, you'll also see, again, this Manage Your Crowdfunding button, and we will go through the details of how that works later as well.